हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक अगेन। सो इन टुडे सेशन वी विल लर्न हाउ टू मेक यूजर डिफाइंड कीवर्ड्स एंड हाउ टू सेपरेट आउट यूजर डिफाइंड कीवर्ड्स एंड वेरिएबल्स योर लोकेटर्स इन अ सेपरेट फाइल्स। सो एज यू कैन सी इन दिस एग्जांपल, दिस ओपन ब्राउजर, बैकजेंस ब्राउजर, दीज आर बिल्ट इन कीवर्ड्स, दीज आर कमिंग फ्रॉम सेलेनियम लाइब्रेरी। बट हाउ कैन वी मेक आवर ओन यूजर डिफाइंड कीवर्ड्स एंड हाउ कैन वी यूज दैट? How can we separate out those keywords in a separate file? How can we make these locators, as you can see, I'm using locators in the same test suite, test case only. So how can we separate out these also in a separate file? As well as we will learn about test setup, test teardown, and suite setup, suite teardown. So in this video, I will tell you all those things. So before moving ahead, please subscribe the channel if you're not yet subscribed and press bell icon for the future notification. So let's get started. So as you can see here, I have a simple, very simple example. It will log in, it will open the browser, it will open the amazon.com and it will log in. So let me first run this CLS. Let me run this first. It will launch amazon.com and it will log in, and then it will close the browser. Browser opened. Now sign in is happening. Sign in successful. Now browser is closed. So as you can see, what is it? Suit teardown failed. Okay. Oh yeah, this is something else. This I have to remove. As you can see, our test case is passed. This teardown, some garbage thing is there, so that I need to remove this. I will remove this. As you can see, we are using our locators in our test suite file itself, and in our test suite itself we have written all those things, all the keywords, all the built-in keywords, all the ID locators, everything we have written inside our test case itself. So what will be the better solution is we should make our user defined keyword, and all those things we should move to that user defined keyword. So how to write a user defined keyword? So that you can write here, like you can see settings test case. So here you need to write, to make a user defined keyword, you will make it under keyword section. So you have to write 3 stars space keywords space 3 star. So in this section, you have to write your own user defined keyword. In keyword we can give any name, like login to Amazon, login to Amazon. You can give this name. In this you can give the documentation as well. I will copy from here. You can give what your function is doing. In documentation, you should write what your function is doing. This should be like here. So this keyword will do login. So we have written our own user defined keyword which will do login. So what we need to put here, what functionality we need to put here, we need to put here all the functionality which is doing login. So we will copy from here, wait until till here. I will cut this and I will paste it here inside the keyword, login to Amazon. So when this is our test case and this is our keyword, inside test case section, whatever you will write, that will be your test case, and inside keyword section, whatever you will write, that will be your keyword that will get called. That will be a function which will get called and which will do the things whatever you have mentioned inside that function or inside that keyword. We will copy the keyword name from here and we will paste it here. Now when our test case will run, it will open browser, first keyword, next line is maximize browser, second keyword, third thing is login to Amazon. This is a third keyword, but this is a user defined keyword, is a custom keyword, it is not a built-in keyword. So this keyword will get called. Our test case will find this keyword is available or not in this file. So this keyword is available here itself, so it will run from here. So let me run this. Our keyword get called. Sign in done. Now teardown is called and browser is closed. Test case is passed. So you can see the result as well. So this is our result file. So here you can see this is open browser built-in keyword. Maximize browser again built-in keyword. Third keyword is login to Amazon, which is our user-defined keyword which get called. And if you expand this, it have executed all these lines, all this functionality which you have mentioned. And after that, your teardown close browser is called. So like this, you can write your own custom keywords or your own user-defined keywords. So if you define like this, your test case will not be very clumsy and it will be easily readable and understandable. There are one more section which is called variable. So you can define this variables. Inside variable section, you can define your variable, whatever input values you are giving. That all you can define here in variable section. How you need to define? Suppose in open browser, some whatever arguments you are giving, whatever values you are giving, that you can define in variable section. In open browser, we are giving two arguments. One is URLs and second one is our browser. So these two we can define here. We can give here like, if you want to define a variable, you have to use dollar sign, curly braces, then variable name, which is URL, two spaces, and you can give value here itself. Control V. Second variable is browser. Again, dollar browser, two spaces, two or three spaces, and you can give, but you have to give more than one. Control X, Control V. So this variable we can call here. First argument is URL, second argument is browser. Let me run this. This will also behave the same. See, sign in happened and now teardown will execute and your browser is get closed. You can see the result here now. So here you can see open browser, user open browser built-in keyword having two variables, URL and browser. Opening browser Chrome to base URL, this it will, if you expand this, it will give you what all values you are passing from here. So this is the Chrome and this is the URL. I want that my all the keywords and all the variables should be in a separate file, and that in my test suite file, this is our test suite file where you are writing the test cases. So if you want in your test suite file only test cases should be there, no keyword definition should be there, your all keyword definition should be in a separate file, all variables and locators should be in a separate file. So how you can do that? So I will tell you how to do that. You can make two separate files. One is testkey.robot, which will be your keyword file, and one is test.py, which will be your variable file. So inside script only, I have, as you in left section you can see, just inside script right click new file. So here you are seeing Python file. If you right click on Python file, you can give any name. I have given test.py. .py you no need to give, .py it will take automatically. So your .py file will be your locators file, your variables files, and if you want your keyword file, then you have to make that keyword file as same as you have made for test case. You have to choose robot file, and you have to choose here, one is test suite file. Our test suite file is test.robot, but we want that our keyword file should be created. So we will select robot keywords, and you have to give name. Don't give dot robot, it will take automatically, and it will create your test key.robot or any other name you want to give, you can give. It will keep create your keyword file. I will copy this keyword, I will remove from here, and I will put it here in my keyword file like this. I can put my user defined keyword inside a keyword file. Now it comes to variable file. In your variable file, what you will put in your variable file, you can give your locator names, your locators, your ID, XPath, whatever you are giving, whatever you are using, or any values also, if you are using that also, you can give, and you can call in your test suite file. So how to do that? So in your variable file, how you will define it? In your variable file, you will define, you can give any name in your you can write any name like sign in link, and you can define it like this, your name variable name equal to double quotes ID equal to this. Like this you should define. You should, in your variable file you should not use dollar sign, you should use only when you are calling it. So other keywords also we can define like this. This is the same thing, this is also same thing. Then this is the username ID, so this also I can like that, like this, username UNID equal to ID equal to control V. So like this you should define your or locators in a separate py file, and you should call these locators in your keyword file, in your keyword definition, using dollar sign. So how you will call this? Now this is our this thing. So sign in link, how you will call this? You will call it like dollar control V, like this you should call it. As I already told you, when you call the variables or the locators from py file, you should always use dollar sign. But when you're defining it in your py file, you should not use dollar sign, you should use simple names. But when you're calling it, you should use dollar sign. Inside curly braces you need to call it. Link is done. Here also same thing. After that email, so email is this one, control C, dollar control, control C, control V, control C, control V, here also control V. So after making your variables files, your locator files and your keyword file, how you will include those files in your test suite so that your test suite should call these files and should execute the functionality. I just changed the name of the files, so don't get confused. My test suite file is test suite.robot, keyword file is keyword.robot, and variable file is variable.py. And I have put all these two files. My test suite file is still in script folder, and my py file and my keywords file is, I have make one more folder which is resource folder. I have put all those files in my resource folder. So how will I call these two files in my test suite file so that it can call the required keywords? So for calling the resource file, or calling the variable files in your test suite, you have to write like this. Inside setting section, you have to write a resource. To call your keyword file, you should write resource, and to call your variable file, you should write variables. So in resource, you should write resource slash keyword dot robot, and for variables, you should write resource slash variables dot py. I have put these two files in the resource folder, which is one step back from script folder. Means I have to get out from script folder and then I have to get into resource folder. So to getting out from script folder, I have to put two dot and then resource folder and then py file and robot file. So like this, I have, now you can see we have our keywords file ready, we have our py file, the variable files ready, and this is our keyword file. I have already told you how you can call this, and I have already told you how to make the keywords. This are the variable files, all the variables, all the locators we have put here. I have told you, you have to call this variable using dollar sign. I have put dollar sign here. And now in the test suite file, I have to call all these two files in resource and variables. The keyword which we are calling is login to Amazon, which is defined in our keyword login to Amazon. So let me run this now. Robot test suite dot robot. See, our sign in is happening. Sign in successful. And our test case is passed. I have some more keywords which I have already prepared. So let me include those keywords also here. I have some more keywords here. Let me include those keywords in my keyword file. I will not put all those things in test suite file because now I have all my keywords files here. So I will put all those things in my keyword file. So now what we will do is, after logging, we need to perform some more functionality. Let me tell you what all we should perform. Let me tell you what all I will perform here. After logging in, it will click on this again and it will go to your account and it will open all these pages and it will just verify that click is happened and page is open. That's it. This page is open. Again, go to your account. Now we have some more keywords in our keyword file. So all those keywords we will call. Before that, what we will do, these all the locators we already have a separate file. So this all locators we will put in a separate our py file. This is the nav link, is same thing. So we will put this thing here, sign in link, which is already we have. So I will put this here. The keyword which we already have, we can reuse that. The variable which we already have in our PYL file, we can reuse that. But if we don't have any keyword or any variable in our file, then we have to create a new one. So this thing we already have, we are already using in our login keyword, so we can use this. This order page we will use here with dollar sign. Yeah, so like this our keyword and keyword file and variable file is ready. Now we have to call all those keywords in our test case. So how we will call? As we were calling our first keyword login to Amazon, in the same way we will call all those keywords also. First this one, account page will open. First open the browser, then maximize window, then login. After that, fourth keyword is account page will open. Fifth keyword is this. Sixth is prime. Seventh is this. After that, profile layer, okay, account order prime gift. How many I have written? Account order prime gift, then profile. Okay, and after that, device. This is how you should, and after that the last one is our logout. So this is how your test case should looks like. It should not have any clumsy code, any so many variables, so many keyword definitions in it. It should have only the keywords in it, whatever functionality you are calling in your test case. So only keywords I am putting in my test case. The keywords will have their own definition, which I have already given here. It will use some locators, which I have mentioned here. So now let me call this, let me run this. Our first keyword which will sign in, first keyword is done. After that, second keyword which will open your account, and after that different tabs it will open. Something has went wrong, let me check this. And now this is our last keyword, which is sign out functionality. It will click on sign out and our test case is passed. We are signed out successfully. How can you reuse a keyword functionality? Here, if you see in my keywords file, if you see this sign in link visible enabled, click sign in, wait until page contains your account is visible. This same thing I'm using inside different keywords, this four lines, sign in, click sign in, then this. Here also you can see in prime page, in gift card page, this thing. So this four lines I'm using repeatedly in my different keywords. So as we already have one separate keyword with these four lines, so we should call that keyword inside our another keyword. So what can we do here is, with writing these four lines again and again, we can call this keyword itself inside our other keywords. I will copy this and I will paste it here with these four lines. Here also with these four lines. These four lines again. Because these four lines I'm using again and again. And I already have one separate keyword with these four lines, so I can call that keyword itself inside my another keyword, which will give you reusability as well as which will reduce your line of code as well. So if you have some lines of code which you are using again and again in another keywords, in more than one keywords, so better you should keep those common lines in one keyword and call that keyword inside another keyword, which will give you reusability functionality as well as which will reduce your line of code. Like this, you can separate out your variables, your keywords from your test suite file. So you can see the result as well, how this is get called. So this is the result. Here you can see open browser built-in keyword, then maximize browser built-in keyword. After that, this all are user defined keywords. Log into Amazon, then open account, open order, prime. If you go to these keywords, you will find your page account, your account page opens up. This is the keyword, this is the same keyword here which we have reused in other keywords. So here. So like this, you can call a keyword inside another keyword, you can get the reusability, you can separate out your files. So hope you enjoyed the video. We'll meet you in next session. If you not yet subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel. Stay connected. Till then, bye bye.